Today we're going to take this modern photo and give it an old rustic look. Hello and welcome to another Affinity Revolution tutorial. Today we'll be taking this beautiful picture of me and my wife on our wedding day and give it an old rustic look. I've included a download link in the description if you'd like to follow along with the same photo, or feel free to use one of your own photos. The techniques we learned today will work on pretty much any photo. The first thing we need to do to make our photo look old is turn it black and white. This is really easy to do. We just come to the adjustments icon over here, this circle, press on that, and then click black and white. Here we can choose how light or how dark certain colors become in our photo. For this photo in particular, I like making the reds a little bit darker and then making the yellows darker, and I leave the rest of it alone. But for your own photo, you can choose with these sliders how light and dark certain colors become. And when you're satisfied with your black and white look, just click on this X, and now you can check it on and off to see how your black and white looks. Now that our photo is in black and white, we're going to give it a more rustic look by giving an orange lens filter over it. We can do this by going back to the adjustments, and then near the bottom, there's one called lens filter. Here you can see it's already turned it orange, making it look much older. I think 50% is a little too much, so I'm gonna drop this down to 40%, just so it's not quite as orange. But you can adjust it however you like. Maybe you like having a really orange photo. That's perfectly okay, personal preference. I'm gonna keep mine at 40% though. And when you're done, just press the X, and again, we can turn this on and off. Our photo is looking pretty good, but I think a light vignette would really add to this picture. To add a vignette, we first need to select our photo layer. In this case, it's the background, and then come up to Layer, New Live Filter Layer, and then Vignette Filter. Here with these sliders, we can choose how light or dark our vignette is, and change whether it's a complete harsh circle or a very faint vignette. So again, I'll keep this somewhere in the center, and then the scale, you can choose whether it comes all the way in or back out. So I'm gonna keep it backed out pretty far. And the shape, I'll just keep at 100%. So when you've adjusted these sliders the way you want, you can exit out of this. And now underneath our background with this triangle, you can see the vignette filter applied. So you can check it on and off to see. Ours is a pretty subtle one in this photo, but you can make a more harsh and contrasted one if you so desire. If at any time you want to change your vignette or any of the other layers, you can just double click on the icon and the sliders will come back up. So maybe I will make this a little bit darker. I think that's good. The next thing we're going to do is add a little bit of noise to this photo. You know, give it that grainy look that old photos have. So to do this, again, we select our background and then come up to Layer, New Live Filter Layer, and this time we'll select Add Noise Filter. And now we can crank this up to make our photo look more pixelated. Obviously 100% is a little too strong. I'm gonna make mine maybe 15%. It doesn't need to be overwhelming. You don't want a really grainy photo, but just enough that you can see a little difference, add a little bit of grain to your photo. The last thing we're going to do today is make this photo a little darker. Right now it's really bright, but we can add a nice dark layer to it by clicking on the rectangle tool over here and then drawing a rectangle over our photo. It doesn't matter if you draw over the photo, you can draw down here if you want, and that won't make a difference. And our rectangle needs to be black, not white, so we can just switch the colors up here. Now it's a black one. But as you can see right now, it's covering up our entire photo, So to change that, we're going to go from a normal blend mode down to soft light. Now you can see it's really darkened our photo. Personally, I think it's darkened it too much, so I'm going to drop down the opacity down to, say, maybe 60, 65%, somewhere around there. And I can check this on and off to see the effect that gave my photo. Oh yeah, check it back on. And with that, we have just completed our olden day photo. We started with a very modern looking wedding photo and have easily turned it into this old rustic looking photo. And the techniques we use today can be applied on any photo, so feel free to take any photo you have and give it this old rustic look. And if you want to see future tutorials similar to this one, then please subscribe to our channel. We'll be coming out with more fun tutorials in the future. Other than that, that wraps up our tutorial for today, and I'll catch you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.